could be before it and could be with it.
القرآن الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خيرا. وأسك الله بليس أول فيو سيئان. وأسك الله سبحانه وتعالى ميك إت إيزي فور أول أوف أس. وأسك الله بروتكت أس إن دنيا إن آخرة. وأسك الله ميك إت ميك أس هابي إن دنيا إن آخرة يا رب العالمين. وأسك الله ميك أور جريف بارت أوف الجنة إن سيف أس فروم النار. آمين يا رب العالمين. And all those brothers and sisters, whoever in masjid and whoever in live streaming, watching, the viewers, please remember us in the best of your dua. I'm asking you sincerely by the name of Allah that remember us in the best of your dua, inshallah. For us, dua of Rasul, saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dua al-akhi li-akhihi bi-dhahir al-ghayb mustajab. The dua of any brother to his brother in his absence is acceptable. We ask Allah to accept all of our own good deeds, accept all of our dua, and the angel will say, وَلَكَ بِمِثْلِ. Angel will say, and for you, equal to whatever you do dua for him. Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah, we, the last time, finished the ruqya. What's the meaning of ruqya, and what's the conditions of ruqya, and what is the ayat of ruqya, what is the ahadith of ruqya, and what is the every details, or at least I can say, majority of the details about الرقية alhamdulillah رب العالمين was done. And I remember that الإمام السيوطي said أجمع العلماء على جواز الرقية بشروط ثلاث. The ulama agreed upon that the ruqya is a jaiz with three conditions. Number one, by the word of Allah like the Quran, by the word of Allah like them. Also what we learned the last time of the dua of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم by the names of Allah, by the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Rahman, al-Rahim, al-Malik, al-Quddus, al-Salam, al-Mu'min, al-Mu'minu, al-Azizu. Also the second condition must be with al-Lisan al-Arabi wa ma yu'rafu ma'na. By the Arabic language, like the ayat of the Quran in Arabic, like the hadith of Rasulullah in Arabic, and with whatever is known in other language but is known, understandable, translation of it or something like that, no problem, inshallah. But something, the meaning of it is known and is not something you don't know what the meaning of it and it is talasim. Allah knows what it is. No. Number three, أن يعتقد أن الرقية لا تؤثر بذاتها بل بتقدير الله عز وجل. The third condition, you have to have belief, you have to have عقيدة, إيمان, that it does, the رقية does not do by itself. It is by Allah. Allah makes the رقية as a reason to give you shifa. الإمام أحمد, this is now we will move to another point. الإمام أحمد عن عطاء الخرساني قال لقيت وهب بن منبه وهو يطوف بالبيت. He said I meet وهب بن منبه while he is doing طواف around the بيت. And I said to him, please say to me one of the hadith and one of the hadith of Rasulullah to me memorized from you. He said, okay. نعم. أوحى الله تبارك وتعالى إلى داود. Allah revealed to داود, يا داود. Listen carefully to this point. أما وعزتي وعظمتي لا يعتصم بي عبد من عبادي دون خلقي أعرف ذلك من نيته فتكيده السماوات السبع ومن فيهن والأراضون السبع والأرضون السبع ومن فيهن إلا جعلت له من بينهن مخرجا. Listen carefully, so beautiful. Allah Azza wa Jal saying and swearing by his izzat, by his glory, by his majesty, by his greatness, that anyone hold fast with Allah, and anyone depend and trust Allah, and anyone worship Allah alone, and he does not worship the people, he does not depend on only the people, he does not only his trust on money or on the people. Allah said, I know that from his intention. Because Allah knows your intention. Allah knows the intention. For that Allah said, I know that from his intention. if he have that pure tawheed to Allah, pure trust to Allah, complete and perfect depend upon Allah, then if the whole seven heaven and whoever in it, and the whole seven earth and whoever in it, human being and the jinn, like the other hadith, from the human being and the jinn from beginning till the end, all of them, if they make an evil plot against you, seven heaven and whatever in it, and seven earth and whatever in it, whole human being and the jinn make an evil plot against you, Allah will make for you exit from it. Means you will be safe, you will be protected. Listen to the rest. أما وعزتي وعظمتي لا يعتصم عبد من عبادي بمخلوق دوني أعرف ذلك من نيته إلا قطعت أسباب السماء من يده وأسخت الأرض من تحت قدميه ثم لا أبالي بأي أوديتها هلك. الله عز وجل swear by his name, by his عزت, by his عظمة, by his glory, by his majesty, by his greatness. Anyone does not depend upon Allah and depend upon the makhluk. Does not worship Allah, worship the. Does not worship Al-Khaliq, worship the makhluk. Does not worship Allah and worship the people. Or trust the people only. Or fear from the people only. Or as already opposite of the tawheed, the shirk. Allah said, and I will know that from, I already know that from his intention, his niyat. Except, I will cut all the reason from his hand. All the reason will be, he will never able to protect himself, and nobody will be able to protect him. And Allah said, I will make the land to, if Allah want, to swallow him. And Allah said, I don't care in any place he will be, or in any shape he will be destroyed. Which one you love for your own self, brother? To be protected, and first one, to be protected, and to be depend upon Allah, trust Allah alone. Think always about worshiping Allah only. Learn the religion. Then one of the part of it, do not tamaim. Tamaim is some people they put some of the things for the kids at the top here, black. Sometimes some different country, different colors. Some country red stone. Sometimes they hang it in there in a robe or on a thread with a red stone. Some people. Blue one, some people, different things, thinking that this will be protecting him. This is also shirk. And Sa'id ibn Jubir قال, من قطع تميمة من إنسان كان كعدل رقبة. رواه وقيع. When you say it and you are able to do, with the people who is under your responsibility. Why I'm saying under your responsibility? Like from your family, from somebody who is under your responsibility, do. But if somebody else, only just advice. Somebody from another family, from another country, from, and you have no any authority upon him. Just you are only requested to do advice, no more than this. If you cut it and you throw it away after explanation to them that this is shirk, the one only one can protect you is Allah Azza wa Jal, then it will be equal to manumitting a slave. It will be equal to buying a slave and freeing him. Also, there is other hadith thinking of getting the barakah, the blessing from other than Allah Azza wa Jal. Thinking of getting the blessing from other than Allah. Like what? Getting the blessing from a tree, getting the blessing from the graves, and especially the graves. Some of the people, they say, we worship Allah alone, but only we're going there, our dua is acceptable, and we get more blessing. No. The source of the blessing in Islam is only Allah Azza wa Jal. Go to Tirmizi. Hadith number 2181 in the book of Al-Fitan, and go to Imam Ahmad, volume number 5, hadith number 218, عن أبي واقد الليثي قال خرجنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى حنين. We went out with Rasulullah to Hunain. ونحن حدثاء عهد بكفر. And we was new Muslim and very near to the kufr time. وللمشركين سدرة أي شجرة يعكفون عندها. And for the Mushrikeen, some kind of a tree, they used to sit around it and do like i'tikaf, as is the word it's saying. وَيَنُوتُونَ أَن يُعَلِّقُونَ بِهَا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ. And they used to put their own weapons and their own sword upon it, hang it upon it. تَبَرُّكًا بِهَا وَتَعْظِيمًا لَهَا. This is the moon point. Why they are doing that, sitting around this tree and putting, hanging their sword and their weapons upon it. As a way thinking for them, believing that getting more blessing, and also a way of respect to that tree, a way of not a respect like worshiping. This is what I can say. A way of worshiping, a way of that greatness. This tree is a greatness. Do you know that people who do the idol, instead of idol, it is tree. Instead of a tree, it is grave. Instead, only the worship must be directed to Allah. And any kind of worship, because dua, people thinking that is not a worshiping. It is by part of the worship. Must be directed to Allah alone. When you ask, ask Allah alone. When you depend upon Allah alone. When you seek help from Allah alone. Nothing else. In another narration of Hadith Amr, وَكَانَتْ تُعْبَدُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. This tree they used to worship it, other than Allah or beside Allah. وَفِيهِ بَيَانٌ أَنَّ عِبَادَتُهُمْ لَهَا بِالتَّعْظِيمِ وَالْعُكُوفِ وَالتَّبَرُّكِ. It is very clear in the Hadith that what kind of worship? Do they do sujood to it? No. It is by thinking that it is a great, thinking that it is must be respected, thinking that it is when they sit beside it, they will get some more blessings. This is a kind of worship they are doing. And this tree, يُقَالُ لَهَا ذَاتُ أَنْوَاطٍ. They name it ذَاتُ أَنْوَاطٍ. فَمَرَرْنَا بِسِدْرَةٍ. They are passing some of the Sahaba and they are new Muslims, they don't know. And was passing upon this kind of a tree while they are doing that to it. For that when they pass another one. Listen to what they said. قلنا يا رسول الله اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط. O رسول الله, make for us the same like them. Make this tree for us to put our own sword and getting more baraka, and we will sit around it as they have. فقال ظنوا أن هذا الأمر محبوب عند الله وقصدوا به التقرب. They think that this is will be beloved to Allah, and they think that it will be they will get near to Allah as a people of the graves, عباد القبور, worshipers of the graves. They think the same way, thinking that when they are doing that, this is something beloved to Allah, and this is a way of respect to them, and they want to be near to Allah through them. Right or wrong? If any one of you here is thinking that anything of what I'm saying, you can ask, inshallah. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الله أكبر وفي رواية سبحان الله. Amazing. الله أكبر. Should you stop? No. سبحان الله. إنها السنن. قلت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفسي بيده كما قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. قال إنكم قوم تجهلون. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, glory be to Allah. سبحان الله. You are saying the same by Allah of what Bani Israel said to Musa. Make for us ilah as they already themselves has ilah. And this is alaykum salam. This is in Surah Al-A'raf, Surah number 7, verse number 138. بمعنى, what's the meaning of it after this ayah? شبه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مقالتهم هذه بمقالة بني إسرائيل لموسى. He make it equal to what they say, equal to what the people of Israel saying to سيدنا موسى. بجامع أن كلا طلب أن يجعل له ما يؤلهه ويعبده من دون الله. What is the thing is wasn't both of them the same? That those people, they said make for us إله as they have. Those when they see these people worshiping the tree, are getting the blessing from the tree. Oh, our Rasulullah make us for us something like that and we will get the blessing from it. The blessing in Arabic, baraka. Baraka from Allah only. The source of baraka in Islam, not from any grave. Not from any tree, not from anything else, only from Allah al-Wahid al-Ahad. وَإِنْ اخْتَلَفَ اللَّفْظَانِ فَالْمَعْنَى وَاحِدٌ فَتَغَيُّرُ الْإِسْمِ لَا يُغَيِّرُ الْحَقِيقَةِ. Even the two words is different, the word there and the word here, but the same meaning in both. Jazakallah. The same meaning in both of them. What is the meaning of this hadith again? طلبوا شجرة يؤذن لهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيها فيتبركون بها ويعلقون عليه أسلحتهم دون أن يصلوا لها دون أن يتصدقوا لها فبين لهم أن طلبوا من ذلك التبرك ولو لم يكن صلاة ولا صدقة ولا سجودا إنما هو الشرك بعينه. They ask him, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, to give them permission to get the blessing from that same kind of a tree and to put their sword upon it in order to have more barakah, in order when they fight they will be good victory. they never ask رسول الله to pray for it, they never ask رسول الله to give some صدقه toward it, they never ask رسول الله to do سجود for it. But رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم make it clear to them that asking the blessing بركة in Arabic from other than Allah, even there is no salah, even there is no صدقه, even there is no سجود, it is the shirk itself. وإنما كان عباد الأوثان وعباد القبور في أيامنا يعتقدون حصول البركة منها بتعظيمها ودعائها والاستعانة بها والاعتماد عليها في حصول ما يرجون منها يرجونه منها ويؤملونهم ببركتها وشفاعتها والاعتقاد والظن أنها تنفع وتضر. Listen carefully to this point, very important. The people who worship the idols at the time of before Islam, جاهلية time. And the people now who are worshipping the graves, even they do not think that they are worshipping. But look to both of them, it's the same in Islam. Those who used to worship in the idols, what is in their mind, and what they say, we are worshipping Allah through them, right? Same with what the people of the graves, they said, we are worshipping Allah through them. With another way, they say that our dua there is acceptable. And they respect it, and they think that it is a grave. And they do dua asking them, and they depend upon them, and they seek help from them, and they trust them. And even if they see some of the dream shaitan make it to them, Ya Rabbi, it becomes so huge and so big. And whatever they want, they ask them only. And whatever they hope of barakah, of blessings, they think that they will get it from it. And they will think that they will do shafa'ah to them. By Allah, this is exactly the same of what the people of the idols used to do to the idols. They ask them for barakah, blessing. They depend upon them. They seek help from them. And it is explained in the Quran very clear. They think that the idols will help them and will benefit them and will harm them. Same with the thinking of the people. Read any story or listen to any story of the people who serve the graves. They will scare you. Look, this man, he was against them. And he lost his cow and he lost his house and he lost his money, and one of his children, he died. A'udhu billah. All of this in hand of Allah alone, not in hand of anybody, of the human being. For that this is, even if they are thinking that they are not worshipping it, and they think this action is not a worship, it is in Islam. When you ask, ask Allah alone. When you depend, depend upon Allah alone. Jazakum Allah khair. When you seek help from Allah alone. If you seek help from Allah and from the graves, or the man in the graves, seek help from Allah and depend upon Allah and depend upon them. Fear Allah and fear them. You make them equal to Allah. You make them to equal. As one of the brothers one time asked me a very good question, saying, is there any harm in Islam or Allah or Rasulullah? After I argue a lot of time, Allah or Rasulullah say, if I do not go, after he already convinced and accept that should not be going with what the people doing, if I don't go, is there any punishment to me? I said, no, there is no any punishment. Actually, there is no any order is opposite. Do not go. If you see them worshipping it, depend upon it, asking them only, fear from them, then you should not go. The punishment will happen to you if you go, because you are helping the same shirk of way of shirk. But look, also the question will tell you something. When he says that, if I don't go, is there any punishment I have? Means they put in his mind, they plant it, and this is what they do. Scare the people. Oh, if you do not do that, and if you do not give the sadaqah you're doing daily or monthly or yearly, oh, you will be punished. You will lose your health. You will lose your wealth. Subhanallah. No. النافع هو Allah. The one who benefits you, Allah. الضار ومانع الضرر, the one who prevent the harm to come to you, is only Allah Azza wa Jal, nobody else. Also, one of the calamities of the shirk, go to Surah Al-Nahl, Surah number 16, verse number 98 and 99 and 100. Allah said, فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إنه ليس له سلطان على الذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون إنما سلطانه على الذين يتولونه والذين هم به مشركون. Allah says, so when you recite the Quran, say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. seek refuge from Allah against the shaitan. Also right to say with Allah against the shaitan. Seek refuge with Allah against shaitan. Or from shaitan, the cursed one. Verily, shaitan has no power over those who believe, over those who mu'min. Shaitan have no power over the believers. And have no power over those who put their trust only in Allah. Means shaitan have no power, shaitan have no authority, he cannot do nothing with the believer, and more with those who put their trust in Allah. For that if you put your trust in others than Allah, or instead of believer you are a mushrik, shaitan will control you. Same ayah, shaitan, his power is only over those who obey and follow shaitan. And those who bihi mushrikun in the ayah, they join partners with Allah through the shaitan. They join partners with Allah through the shaitan. As I told you, there is a nuniyah for Ibn al-Qayyim about the tawheed and about al-iman with the sifat, with the qualities and the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is very known, the nuniyah is so beautiful and the meaning of it in Arabi so beautiful and so good. Because all of it end with al-Nukrani, al-Imani, al-Irfani, al-Qur'ani with the noon. Nuniyah comes from the letter noon. End of it like that. Zutibiani, al-Shani, al-Shana'ani, al-Azmani, al-Ihsani, Mumtani'ani, Mi-Qur'ani, wal-Furqani till the end. But the meaning of it, subhanAllah, as I already told you last time, some of it, ساروا بإثبات الصفات إليه للتعطيل والتحريف والنكران عرفوه بالأوصاف فامتلأت قلوبهم له بالحب والإيمان فتطايرت تلك القلوب إليه بالأشواق إذ ملئت منه من العرفان أشدهم حبا له أدراهم بصفاته وحقائق القرآن فالحب يتبع للشعور وبحسبه يقوى ويضعف ذاك ذو تبيان. Let us take some of the meaning. But as you know, when you translate any Arabic, you kill the beauty of the language completely. But at least we know some of the meaning. Is it the believer? They will go and believe in the qualities of Allah. They will not stop the meaning of it. They will never twist it. They will never deny it. Because they know Allah through His quality. And their heart is full of love to Allah and full of iman. And this heart is flying to Allah with hope. Because it's full of knowing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the one who have more strong love to Allah is the one who have more knowledge about the qualities of Allah and about the truthness and about the knowledge of the Quran. Because your love will follow your knowledge. And according to the knowledge and according to the feeling you have, your love will be strong or weak. Weak feeling and weak understanding and weak knowledge, you'll have weak love to Allah. And strong knowledge and strong feeling toward Allah and strong understanding, it will give you strong love to Allah. Listen to the rest. وَلِذَاكَ كَانَ الْعَارِفُونَ بِصِفَاتِهِ أَحْبَابَهُ هُمْ أَهْلُ هَذَا الشَّانِ وَلِذَاكَ كَانَ الْعَالِمُونَ بِرَبِّهِمْ أَحْبَابَهُ وَبِشِرْعَةِ الْإِيمَانِ وَلِذَاكَ كَانَ الْمُنْكِرُونَ لَهَا هُمُ الْأَعْدَاءُ حَقًّا هُمْ أُولُو الشَّنَآنِ وَحَيَاةُ قَلْبِ الْمَرْءِ فِي شَيْئَيْنِ مَنْ يُرْزَقْهُمَا يَحْيَى مَدَى الْأَزْمَانِ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْأُخْرَى يَكُونُ الْحَيُّ ذُو الرِّضْوَانِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ ذِكْرُ الْإِلَهِ وَحُبِّهِ مِنْ غَيْرِ إِشْرَاكٍ بِهِ وَهُمَا فَمُمْتَنِعَانِ. Some of the meaning. It's those people who knows Allah and know the qualities of Allah, they love Him. And they are the people who deserve that love. And for those who know their Lord and they love Him, they are a mu'min and they follow the Islamic law. And those who deny the qualities of Allah, they are the enemy. And be careful of them, they will be your enemy. The life of your heart in two things. If you get it, you will be alive forever in dunya and akhirah. In dunya and akhirah, Allah will be happy and pleased and protecting you, and He will be aiding and supporting you. What it is the two thing? Remembering Allah always without any kind of shirk. Remembering Allah means the tawheed without any kind of shirk. Then he said, وَهُمَا فَمُمْتَنِعَانِ. Both of them cannot be together. Can you find tawheed and shirk inside the same heart? No. Iman and kufr can be in the same heart at the same minute? No. Like fire and water in the same place? No. In the same minute. If it is in separate, it is, but I'm talking about the heart. For that, shirk and tawheed, opposite of each other, cannot be in the same. Then he follow and saying, أَيُحِبُّهُ مَنْ كَانَ يُنْكِرُ وَصْفَهُ لَا وَالَّذِي حَقًّا عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى مُتَكَلِّمًا بِالْوَحْيِ وَالْفُرْقَانِ أَيُحِبُّهُ مَنْ كَانَ يُنْكِرُ وَصْفَهُ وَعُلُوَّهُ وَكَلَامَهُ بِقُرْآنِ لا والذي حقا على العرش استوى متكلم بالوحي والفرقان الله أكبر ذاك فضل الله يؤتيه لمن يرضى بلا حسبان الله أكبر ذاك عدل الله يقديه على من شاء من إنسان وله على هذا وهذا الحمد في الأولى وفي الأخرى هما حمدان حمد لذات الرب جل جلاله وكذاك حمد العدل والإحسان. Listen to the beautiful meaning of it. Do you think that anyone will love Allah and he will demand him, or he will demand his names, or he will demand his qualities, and he will demand his being over the throne, or he will demand that the Quran? Impossible. For that the one who, then he swear by Allah, the one who, by the name of the one who is rose over his arsh and talking by the Quran, that Allah will give the superiority to the one who will be accepting Allah and accepting the names of Allah and accepting the qualities of Allah and believing in it. And this is the justice and the fair from Allah. He will give it to whom he will. And for Allah, alhamd and the praise all the time in dunya and in akhirah. And it will be two hamd, hamd in dunya and hamd in akhirah. Hamd for the glory of Allah and hamd for the justice he is doing. ويرون أن أمامهم يوم اللقاء لله مسألتان شاملتان ماذا عبدتم ثم ماذا قد أجبتم من أتى بالحق والبرهان وتيقنوا أن ليس ينجيكم سوى تجريدكم بحقائق الإيمان تجريدكم توحيده سبحانه عن شركة الشيطان والأوثان وكذلك تجريد أتباع رسوله عن هذه الآراء والهذيان والله ما ينجي الفتى من ربه شيء سوى هذا بلا رواغاني. Listen to that carefully and very beautiful also. He said those who believe in Allah and accept Him and love Him and they fear Him only and they do not have any shirk, they have two things very important. They will be able to answer it in their grave and in the Akhirah. Number one, what did you worship in dunya? Ask yourself this question. Are you worshiping Allah alone? Or you leaving? Remember when I said in my khutbah, a very important point, brothers. In previous religions, I don't want to specify anyone, but it is very known. They put upon themselves whatever they never commit, the sin of Adam. They did not commit it, and they put it upon themselves. And they take the sins they already commit, put it upon the one who never do it, which it is Jesus. This is a very important point, say and explain it to everyone. Where is the justice? Where is the justice in this aqidah, in this belief? This is what they believe. They born with the sin, right or wrong? They born with the sin from Adam. For that they put upon themselves is something they never do it. And whatever they do, whatever they already do, committing of sin, oh, they are free from it because they already put it upon Jesus, which he never did it. They put upon themselves whatever they never commit, and they put whatever they do of sin, committing of sin and crimes, upon the one who never do it. Where is the justice in Islam? وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. Nobody will bear any sin of any other one. And you will never ever be accounted in Islam about the sin of the other. You will be accounted about your own only. We do not inherit from Adam, because Adam in Islam already forgiven. Firstly, he does not have a sin already. He is a pure. For that, we do not inherit anything from him. And we will never be accountable about him. Okay? And our own sin, nobody else will bear it. And nobody else will be accountable. Allah does not kill nobody in order to forgive us in Islam. Very important this point. Allah is not very weak. Need to sacrifice his beloved son in order to forgive. Allah is a forgiver, subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that here he say, the first question you will be asked, who you are worshipping? Are you worship Allah alone or Allah and? Three, Allah and the spirit and the whatever else. No. Second question you will be, what did you or who you follow in this worldly life? Did you follow the one who bring to you the truth, which it is the Quran and Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And this two question is, La ilaha illallah, huh? Muhammad Rasulullah. What did you worship, which it is, La ilaha illallah, worship Allah alone. And who you are following? Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The believer will answer that very easily. It does not depend upon that you know the question and answer in the worldly life. No. It will depend upon, did you do according to it or not? Then he said, be sure that you will never be saved except by making pure sincerely of Iman and believing Allah alone and following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and making far away from any kind of shirk, especially the shirk of shaitan in al-awthan. Shaitan, which it is Satan, al-awthan, which it is idols of any kind. Because the idols in these days, it could be the money, it could be the graves, it could be the trees, it could be anything you believe in it that it will save you or protect you. Some people have in their homes some of the idols, some of the shapes of things have a spirit, and they believe in it that this is will be bringing blessing in house and will prevent the shayateen. No, this is itself is shaitan. Then he said, after Allah, make sure that you are a real follower of Sunnah of Rasulullah, no any kind of bid'ah. And he swear by Allah, nothing can save you in the hereafter except this two. Then he said, Ya Rabbi jarrid abdaka al-miskin, raji al-fadla minka ad'afa al-ubdani, lam tansahu wa dhakartahu faj'alhu la yansaka anta bada'ta bil-ihsani, nahnu al-ula zalamu, wa in lam taghfir al-dhanb al-azim fanahnu dhu khusrani. يا رب فانصرنا على الشيطان ليس لنا به لولا حماك يداني. He said, يا رب, make my own worshiping sincerely to you. And this is superiority and this is a grace from you to me. To the one who is a very weak abd, very weak slave to you. Oh Allah, you never forget me. Make me never forget you. Look how beautiful is it. Oh Allah, you never forget me. Make me never ever forget you. Oh Allah, you start with the goodness to me. Make me good to you. Oh Allah, I am the one who commit the sin. And you are the only one forgive all kind of sin. If you do not forgive my sin, I will be the most loser one in this worldly life. Oh Allah, give us victory against shaitan. Oh Allah, there is no anyone can help us on all of this except you only. Look how beautiful is it? So beautiful and so meaningful. For that, let us move to another point in Surah Al-An'am, verse number 162. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهِ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ قُلْ أَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْغِي رَبًّا وَهُوَ رَبُّ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Listen carefully to the meaning. Allah say to the people, my salah, my namaz, my worship, my nusuk. What is a nusuk? The slaughtering of the animal. Wa mahyaya, my life. Wa mamati, my death. Only for Allah Rabbil Alameen. But the point I want, slaughtering the animal, because some people they ask, is the slaughter animal kind of worship? Yes. Goes, who give you the permission to slaughter it? Allah. For that must be by the name of the one who give you the permission. By the name of Allah. And when you do it for the sake of Allah. Not for any idols, not for any graves, not for any other than Allah. Even for eating, but the intention, by the name of Allah. Then for something Allah allowed for you. لا شريك له. No shirk in this. Because if you do slaughter the animal, for other than Allah, it will be shirk. And I was ordered of doing that, and I'm the first, one of the first of the Muslims. Say to them, should I take other than Allah as a Lord for me, and He is the Lord of everything? In Surah Al-Kawthar about this point. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Pray to your Lord and slaughter your animal to your Lord. Shaykh al-Islam said, أَجَلُّ الْعِبَادَاتِ الْبَدَنِيَّ الصَّلَاةِ. The highest of the ibadah of your body is a salah. Because it contains your body. وَأَجَلُّ الْعِبَادَاتِ الْمَالِيَّ النَّحْرِ. The highest of the worshipping of you by your money, through your money. When you worship through your body, it is salah. When you worship Allah through your money, using your money for worshipping, it is the highest one is not الصَّدَقَة. It is the slaughtering of the animal. For that Allah جمع بينهما في الآية دليل على وجوب القرب والتواضع والإيمان والإخلاص لله. Allah mentioned both of them. صلاتي for your body, for your body. ونسكي slaughter the animal by your by my money. Allah gathered them together in order to make you to know that must be by the name of Allah and for Allah only, must be purely and sincerely for Him. For that حسن الظن بالله وقوة اليقين, thinking good about Allah and having good trust in Him and make your heart depend upon Him only. Otherwise, it will be, والعياذ بالله, shirk or nifaq or hypocrisy or arrogant or something else. Not only that, not only is the order of Allah to slaughter the animal by the name of Allah, it is the one who do for other than Allah is cursed. لعنة of Allah upon him. Or here. In Muslim, go and look at the hadith 1978 and hadith number 43 and 44 and 45, book of Al-Adahi, Babu Tahrim al-Dhabh li ghayri Allah. And in Imam Ahmad and other, and Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال حدثني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بأربع كلمات. سيد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم taught me four things. Number one, لعن الله من ذبح لغير الله. Curse of Allah upon the one who slaughters the animal for other than Allah. رسول الله start with it. Curse of Allah upon the one who slaughters the animal for other than Allah. Other than Allah contain anything other than Allah. لعن الله من لعن والدي. Curse of Allah upon the one who curses his parents. Part of the cursing of his parent, if he curse a parent of somebody else, then the others, he replied, then it will be taking the same sin. لعن الله من آوى محدثا. Curse of Allah upon the one who protect or help or save the one who do bid'a. محدثا comes from الحدث. And you think in Islam, then you try for a money, for a worldly reason to protect him, to help him, to save him, you are cursed. لعن الله من غير منار الأرض. Curse of Allah upon the one who, do you know if this is the land of you and beside it the land of your neighbor and there is some sign, they dig it in the land, sometimes glasses, sometimes wood, sometimes iron, sometimes whatever, some of the people in order to increase his land, yes, they move it, very good. Curse of Allah upon the one who moved the signs of the land. What the name? Yeah, the border of the land, sign of the border of the land, in order to increase or decrease. And Allah will give you what you deserve or what you ask. Shaykh al-Islam قال, إن الله تعالى يلعن من استحق اللعنة بالقول. سورة الأحزاب, إن الله لعن الكافرين وعد لهم سعيرا. كما يصلي سبحانه على من استحق الصلاة من عباده, هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Allah will give the rahmah and Allah will give the mercy and Allah will give the blessing, the barakah for the one who deserves it and for the one who wants it. And Allah will never give it to the one who doesn't want it. For that, go to Surah Al-Ahzab and say, Allah said, هُوَ الَّذِي, Allah is the one, يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ. Allah is the one who send His salah. His sending salah means His mercy, His blessing upon you and His angel to get you out from the darkness to the light. وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. And He is merciful to the believers. Also, Allah cares the one who deserves the curse. If you do not follow what Allah wants and you are asking for the cursing by your action, not by your tongue, then you will get it. سورة الأحزاب verse number 64 إن الله لعن الكافرين. الله كرس the كافر the disbeliever the one who disbelieve in Allah. What do you want? Let us now move to وما أهل لغير الله به. Whatever slaughter for others than Allah. Whatever slaughter for others than Allah. This ayah itself mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem four different times. This ayah mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem four different times. Number one in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 173. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إنما حرم عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير. Allah forbid حرام for you the dead animal, the blood, and the flesh, the meat of the swine, which is the pigs. وما in the same ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 173. وما أهل به لغير الله and whatever slaughter for others than Allah. Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah number 5, ayah number 3. حرمت عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير forbidden for you the dead animals, the blood and the pigs. وما أهل لغير الله به. Here mentioned the second time. Whatever slaughter for others than Allah. سورة الأنعام verse number 145. This is the third ayah. قل لا أجد فيما أوحي إلي محرما على طاعم يطعمه إلا أن يكون ميتة أو دما مسفوحا أو لحم خنزير. I find nothing it will be forbidden for us except the dead animal أو دما مسفوحا or a blood or a لحم خنزير وما أهل لغير الله به. Whatever for other than Allah. فإنه رجس أو فسقا أهل لغير الله به. But it is impure and impious in the same ayah. أو دما مسفوحا أو لحم خنزير إنه رجس أو فسقا أهل لغير الله به. Whatever impure or impious. Whatever slaughter for others than Allah. In Surah Al-Nahl, number 4. Four times in the Quran Karim still the people in Muslim Ummah, they still slaughter the animal for others than Allah. It depends upon the intention when he do. Do it for Wali. And do it for his Urs. You know Urs. The festivals they do for them. Do it for Al-Mawlid. Mawlid so and so and Mawlid so and so. All of this forbidden in Islam. Not only forbidden by for the one to slaughter. Forbidden for you to eat it. Here, haram. This ayat, what does it mean? Haram for me with the pigs and whatever slaughter for Allah, make it with the pigs. Pigs is haram, right? Whatever slaughter for others than Allah is like the pigs. Forbidden for you to eat it. Same ayah, Surah Al-Nahl, Surah 16, 115. إنما حرم عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير وما أهل لغير الله به. Same meaning. Whatever forbidden for you, the dead animals, the blood, and the pigs, and whatever slaughter for Allah mentioned with them, with the pigs, whatever slaughter for others than Allah, forbidden for you to eat. Forbidden to slaughter for others than Allah, this is one part. Forbidden for the people to eat from it. After slaughter and cooked, somebody invite you for the urs of the wali, so and so, this and that, then never go, firstly. And if you went and you didn't know or something, they give you the meat, do not take it and do not eat it. Because this is slaughter for others than Allah. Even if it have a shubha and you have some doubt about it, better to leave it. For that ما زبح لغير الله أو بإسم غير الله أو ما أعلن عنه أنه منذور به لغير الله حتى ولو قال الذابح باسم الله فالعبرة في النية إن كان الذبح بإسم غير الله أو لغير الله أو للتقرب له لغير الله فهو عبادة لغير الله وتقربا لغير الله وحرام أن تفعل وحرام أن تأكل. Listen carefully to this. Very important of the details of this four ayat. I said go to Al-Baqarah 173, Al-Ma'idah Surah 5 ayah number 3, Al-An'am ayah number 145, and Al-Nahl Surah 16 and ayah number 115. Zameen. Whatever slaughter for other than Allah, or by the name other than Allah, or they swear by the name of Allah that this is for the wali, so on, so even they mention the name of Allah, but it is for other than Allah as a nadr, noon, thal, ra. Or they say, I will mention the name of Allah, but my intention is for the wali. Or he slaughtered by other than Allah, or for other than Allah to make himself near, even by the name of Allah, near to that wali or near to the place in the grave or whatever, it is a ibadah and it is a haram, and it is haram to do and haram to eat. So clear now. ولا ريب أن تقديم الطعام والشراب والنقود وغير ذلك للأموات من الأنبياء أو الأولياء أو الصالحين أو غيرهم أو للأصنام ونحوها رغبة أو رهبة داخل في عبادة غير الله. There is no any doubt. Not slaughtering and not eating. Providing the food. Providing drinking to those people. Giving them some money. Supporting them. Helping them. Aiding them. Giving your animal, especially the horses, for him to ride it. Some people, they ride and they cover him completely and big noise everywhere, all of this shirk. And all of this, even for the awliya, even for the anbiya, for the salihin, the righteous, them themselves, if Allah makes them alive, getting out of their grave, they will deny what you are doing. Because this is the same of what used to be done to the idols, out of fear or out of hope. Remember when I said before, fear and hope to ibadah must be direct to Allah. For that if you fear them, or you hope the barakah from them, or you hope that they will benefit you, or you hope that they will remove your harm, is it a shirk or no? Shirk completely. And Allah does not forgive any kind of shirk. For that, فإذا كان الطعام مصنوعا من لحوم ذبائح المشركين أو شحمها أو مرقها فإنه حرام لأنه ذبيحة للمشرك في حكم الميتة فتحرم وينجس بها ما خالطته من طعام بخلاف الخبز ونحوه ما لم يخالطه شيء من ذبائح المشركين فإنه حل لمن أخذه وهكذا. The meaning of this, if the food itself, some of it of the mushrik, because the one who slaughter for other than Allah, is he a mu'min or a mushrik? Answer me. Mushrik. Eating of the animal of the mushrik, eating of the food of the mushrik, of the meat of the mushrik, allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. You get the point or still no? When he slaughtered for others than Allah for a wali, is he a mu'min or a mushrik? Does Allah forbid for us to eat the slaughter of the animal of the mushrik or no? For that is not only because it is a slaughter for others than Allah, because the one who did it is a mushrik. For that you cannot eat the sabiha of the mushrik. Okay? And if he mixed it with some other food of other people and is not shirk, still there is some impure food in it. You cannot eat it. But what about if it is a bread or something separate? The bread does not have any meat in it. So that if it is separate and pure, if you need, then you can eat. What about if it is money? Can you use it? Of the money provided for them? The money, yes. Where is the proof? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم أخذ الأموال التي في خزائن اللات وقضى منها دين عروة بن مسعود الثقفي ولم يرى تقديمها للات مانعا من أخذها عند القدرة عليها. When they break the lat and the عزة, and there was a lot of money around it, Rasulullah take it and he give it, he put it in a debt of عروة بن مسعود الثقفي to repay, to pay back the money. And even if he knows that it was coming from there, but it does not prevent Rasulullah from using it in a right, using it in a good. Because the forbidden is the slaughter and the meat of the slaughter. Because he is a mushrik, and this slaughter, this meat, slaughter for others than Allah. But the money is not a kind of worship. But if you think that you don't need it and you don't use it and it is haram, also leave it. If Allah make you rich and you don't need it, leave it. The second one in the hadith of Rasulullah, where when, because I'm explaining the hadith, Allah curses the one who slaughter animal for others than Allah, Allah curses the one who curses his parent, Allah curses the one who protect and help and support the one who do bid'ah, Allah curses the one who change the land marks. Also, about the cursing of the parent, one of the kabair, one of the major sin in Islam. And we already explained that before, for that you know, no need for repeating. About the curse of Allah upon the one who do muhdathan, or to protect our herb, muhdathan or muhdithan. Muhdithan bil kasri, man nasara janin, or awahu, or ajarahu, wa hala baynahu wa bayna al-qasas min. For that cares of Allah upon the one who will protect muhdith. Muhdith here different death. Muhdith is the one who do a crime or the one who do wrong. Then you protect him, and you do not want the law to take their to have his punishment. For that, protecting muhdith criminal people is forbidden in Islam. Protecting or helping or support muhdath with a fatha on the dal, the one who will be, you know that he is in making innovation in Islam, making new things in Islam, and you are happy with what he is doing, and you do not deny what he is doing, and you are helping him, supporting him, and you are patient with him. And amazing, ya akhi wallahi, for those people who do bid'ah, they defend their bid'ah, wallahi, more than they defend the sunnah. Talk to any one of those bid'ah people, ya'uzu billah, ya boy, ask Allah save us from them. I myself see. And amazing is that for the sunnah, they will never defend the sunnah equal to their defending of their bid'ah. For that, usually we say, following the Quran and the sunnah, بفهم الصحابة, with understanding of the sahaba and applying it. Why? Because those bid'ah people nowadays, they bring some ayah, twist the meaning of it, this is what does it mean. Why the sahaba does not understand it and does not do it, and Rasulullah does not do it as you say? Are you more understanding to the Arabic language more than Rasulullah, astaghfirullah, more than the sahaba of Rasulullah, part of the sunnah of Rasulullah, whatever he agree or disagree for the sahaba, whatever he agree becomes sunnah to do, whatever he refuse, like these people who bring in siyam, fast day and night, and who they said, I'll pray forever. Third one, he said, I will never marry. They invent something, even part of it was in Islam, salah and siyam in Islam already, but they do it with a way Rasulullah does not do it, for that Rasulullah refuses. For that, here those people who have the bid'ah, they, ya akhi, subhanallah, they defend it and they, because shaitan adorned it to them. قال ابن القيم وكلما كان الحدث في نفسه أكبر كانت الكبيرة أعظم. If the sin he doing and the crime he's doing and the innovation he's doing big, there is no any doubt the sin will be big. Bigger crime, bigger innovation, bigger sin he will have. The fourth part in the hadith and narrated by Imam Ahmad al-Bukhari and Muslim, لعن الله من غير منار الأرض. Cares of Allah upon the one who change, increasing or decreasing. Usually he will not decrease, he will do what? In his part he will increase, but in the other part he will decrease. Do you get my point? This is the land and this is the other land. He will come in the signs, he'll change it a little bit more. For that, he is increasing to his, decreasing the land of the other. Curse of Allah on him. In Bukhari wa Muslim agreed upon, من ظلم شبرا من الأرض طوقه الله يوم القيامة من سبع أراضي. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, whoever even only just a span. Span, how many inches? Very few inches. From the land, he will be punished at the day of Qiyamah. From, and he will be having a burden of seven earth over himself. وَلَيَزُ بِاللَّهِ as a punishment for him for what he do. Now we will move to another point according to the time. We still have 5 minutes for the live streaming. Jazakumullah khair for following. About people thinking that the slaughtering the animal something big, for that they will not do it, but the little thing is it's okay, we can do it. You get my point again. Do not look to the small or the big thing you are doing. Look to who you are disobeying. Example of that. In Imam Ahmad, Book of Zuhd, page number 15, and in Hilya, volume number 1, page number 203. عن طارق بن شهاب أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله سيد دخل الجنة رجل في ذباب ودخل النار رجل في ذباب. A man enter الجنة through a fly. Do you know the flies on buzzer you all the time? Through it. Because of what? Another one enter Jahannam because of the same fly. Because of the fly. Listen to the hadith. They said, how ya Rasulullah? قال مر رجلان على قوم. First one. لهم صنم لا يجوزه أحد حتى يقرب له شيئا. فقالوا لأحدهما قرب لإلهنا شيئا. قال ليس عندي شيء نقربه أبدا. قالوا له قرب ولو ذباب. فقرب ذبابا. فخلوا سبيله فدخل النار. The people worshiping one of the idols, and they never ever let anybody passing through or near to the idols, except they force him. You have to sacrifice something to our Ilah, to the idol. For that, two of the people who were going, they catch the first one saying, do something. He said, I don't have anything. He said, even a fly. Even a fly. He catch one of the fly, slaughter and give it to the idol. Rasulullah said, they left him, but right away he entered where? Hellfire. Because it's not because of the fly. Who he disobey and who he have shirk with? Huh? Allah, it is against Allah. It's not because of the fly, it's because who you are disobeying. Do not look to the sin you are committing, small or a big. Look to who you are disobeying. You are disobeying Allah. Even if it is a small, you are having nothing of the greatness of Allah in your heart then. The second one, قالوا الآخر, قرب أي شيء. قال ما كنت لأقرب أي شيء لأي أحد إلا لله. في رواية, لأقرب لأحد شيئا دون الله عز وجل, ما كنت أفعل. فضربوا عنقه فدخل الجنة. They say to the second one, do قرباني in Urdu, in Arabic sacrifice, in English sacrifice animal, قرب, sacrifice something to the Allah. He said, no, I will never ever sacrifice anything, even a fly, to other than Allah. Only for Allah عز وجل. They cut his neck, he entered الجنة. لا إله إلا الله. رسول الله said, من لقي الله لا يشرك به شيئا دخل الجنة. ومن لقي الله يشرك به شيئا من لقي الله لا يشرك به شيئا دخل الجنة ومن لقيه يشرك به شيئا دخل النار. Whoever meet Allah does not have any kind of shirk, he will enter الجنة. And whoever meet Allah, he have any kind of shirk, including these things, he will enter جهنم والعياذ بالله. وأسك الله to admit us to الجنة. آمين. وأسك الله to save us from النار. And we ask Allah to protect us in dunya and akhirah. And we ask Allah to give us and make the roots of tawheed in our own heart, in our own mind, and make us muwahideen. And we ask Allah to save us from any kind of shirk. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. If there is any questions, we'll answer according to the time. If there is no, inshallah, the azan time, after 3-4 minutes, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The opening of your halakha. Yeah. I thought I missed the opening.
The beginning.
The beginning. Just the when you open the halakha.
Yeah.
You say.
One of the people you asking that where at the beginning.
No. Just.
The beginning here. He did not record it.
Yes.
How long at the beginning?
Just maybe 5 seconds.
It's okay.
So you can. Do you want to repeat that? Just the opening of the halakha. Assalamu alaikum.
In order for him to do it, to put
yes,
it, Allah subhanahu
wa ta'ala.
Was it at the beginning?
Yes.
It was, can I hear it? Can you let me hear it?
Sure.